Just I guess another minute and I'll start. So I'm pretty much just doing a brand new League of Maidens series where it's basically the continuation of the grinding and chatting streams, but under a new title, where I'm more focused on trying to get stronger armor for Leniri. So that's just what I'm doing in today's stream. And for the next couple of LOMP streams after this. So let's just see what happens.
Cadet.
Pretty sensitive. Hey, Apple.
Cadet.
Yeah, the devs will just keep the Easter event going until I guess when they eventually add in the actual major update that they've announced. In which they pretty much delayed it. Alright. Right, another LOM streamer had their opinions about that. Like about like the whole major update being delayed. To which honestly, I don't mind if they delayed the update or whatever. The update and the state of the game. I'm assuming you're talking about Kairis, because I already know that he has a strong hatred for this game now, at least from the last couple of streams that he's done. Like he already has a strong hatred for the game now, but yet he still plays it. Which he pretty much has the right to be angry since he tried to contact, or no, let me rephrase excuse me. He sent a question to the devs and then his question got deleted. In which I don't blame him for getting angry at them for doing that shit. Hey, it's probably frustration for loving the game, knowing it could be better. Yeah, that's essentially what I'm getting from Kairis. Oh, right. Before I continue. All right, time to fight some enemies and beef up my abilities. All right, my mouse. Oh, wow. Yeah, my mouse is pretty sensitive. Alright, that's better. I guess the major update, this will just takes me back to, what I've mentioned, about not announcing a release date, but instead just do, a surprise major update without people realizing that an update's coming, you know? At least, that's what I think the devs should have done, release the update with no release date and just surprise people. Rather than just guaranteeing, a release date, since they did mention that they were going to release the major update during quarter one of 2023. Which, pretty much became a lie at this point. And then we got the Easter update. But at least I'm not complaining. I mean, you tend to get an idea of what the devs are doing just by their actions and how they update their game. So if anything, I'm just keeping my expectations very low, just to avoid frustration in the future. Of course, I shouldn't be joining with this doom and gloom, are you? I'm doing great. And if you remember yesterday, I finally got the weapon that I wanted to get for Asuka in the Discord. Which it took me a lot of, let me see. I think about 100 gacha tickets, and then I finally got the ticket to redeem the god weapon for Asuka. Yeah, just, as I get into a game, I just don't, set up high expectations for what I want to see from it. Since the moment I do put high expectations onto a game, I'll just know that I'm gonna get disappointed very easily. So I just come into games without expecting anything from it, just to avoid the disappointment, down the line. Which, to be fair, not a lot of people have that type of mindset when it comes to games. there's shit games, and then there's good games. Which, it's just up to the person's preference and all that. To determine if they should play it or not. Pretty close to upgrading this. Nah, I'll save that. I'll save the boss, but the boss fight for a little bit later.
Fantastic! your soul.
Okay, completed that already. Alright, now I can upgrade the gravity core.
Welcome, Cadet.
Hey there, Cadet.
Wow! You actually found them! Thank you so much, Cadet!
You're welcome, Williams. You're welcome. and I'll just be right back. All right, I'm back. Thanks. Yeah, I'm just thinking of keeping the BR, the images that I use for starting soon BRB and ending stream, for a little while. Until I get like something new that either I make or something that Roosmar makes for me. We'll just see. Cause of course those images I use, I made those of course. With the screenshots of Minecraft and Scrap Mechanic. I might just change them to Action Time and Ones at some point. I don't know. Just I've really thought much about my stream screens in a good while. Since the ones that I had before had like the Rosalie's logo, but I didn't want to use those anymore since I was no longer a member, or I pretty much stepped down from the Rosalie's group. Most of my stuff here now is all tier 2. Tier 2 stuff. So if anything, I need to get more tier 2 cubes.
which for you.
Remember how, before I just grouped up a bunch of enemies together and then, delivered the final blow? Yeah, I was better off not doing that since it kind of fucks up my chance of, being able to boost my abilities on the bottom right. So just like taking each one enemy at a time, it will allow me to get the buffs. Or allow me to get one buff at a time. So I'm just gonna do that anymore. Or I just won't be grouping a bunch of enemies together anymore. I've only done that just so that I can get the XP for the Awakening level, but yeah. And I'll only do that if I need to level up my Awakening level. Since I did see when you prestige that you're... Oh, of course, your Awakening level starts back at 1. So I'll definitely do the grouping up again if I need to. Or if I want to get a lot of XP. But to get the skill buffs, I just need to kill one enemy at a time. Like, for instance... Just slide into the scene.
Fantastic! Fresh meat!
Hmm.
So what I've heard from like the action timing and devs that supposedly there's been like a little scam going around in which you can obtain like an account that has been suspended, which or that you can buy an account that hasn't been suspended, which is clearly pretty much a scam right there. And I'm assuming that's been happening, I guess, because of the amount of suspensions or the amount of suspended accounts that have been happening recently, according to the devs. And obviously they're very aware of that, so. Why are they being suspended? Hacking? According to them, just like supposedly them abusing the gacha system or something, or abusing like the currency just to get more ahead to the game, which the devs have been pretty strict about, hence why they suspend a lot of a couple of users that have been doing unfair that have been doing things that are pretty much unfair to the rest of the actual time in the community. Essentially, just like, getting ahead, getting more stuff that, just essentially cheating is what I'll call it. As long as it's not to do with modding in the content, I mean, that's what the series is known for. Or cheating and then I guess players being banned because they're abusing the game, or what's the word? Or that they're abusing the reward system to their advantage, which leads them to getting banned. There you go. Exploiting. So the devs are very strict against people who cheat or exploit the reward system in the game, and so they pretty much remind people of who they've suspended whenever they do like their updates and stuff. And yeah, just the devs have been very curious about the whole buying an action time and an account to use, I guess, to like what's the term? Or like you've been banned and then you use just another account to avoid being banned, sort of thing. But except the people already know that it's you. Ban evasion, there you go. Yeah. So I guess that's what the devs from Action Timonen are trying to avoid. People who have been banned doing a ban evasion. And I guess that's why they're trying to avoid. They're trying to, like, they're trying to condemn. They're trying to punish those people who try to do ban evasions, essentially. To be fair though, like, why even cheat in the first place if you're going that low? Like, if you wanted the rewards that badly, you just had to do what everyone else does, just grind until you eventually get them. Like, you don't really need to go that low just to cheat in the game. But yet, these people who get banned do it anyway, and it's their fault for getting involved in that shit. Time to take on a stronghold. Actually, no. Before I take on a stronghold, I need to sell my treasures. Treasures. Trying my best not to have a speech impediment today. All right, let's do this. Still there. Gotta wait till the title here goes away and I can start. Alright.
I will break your spine!
Congratulations!
Thank you.
Fantastic! Fresh meat!
Excellent!
Yeah, in the strongholds, this is where grouping all the enemies together is necessary. Just so I can just get a final blow on them.
I will break the spine.
Congratulations! Congratulations!
Any luck with the boss drops yet, by the way? In this game, in this game and with Leniri, so far, not yet. Apart from this piece of gear here, but it's not that great for me to use since it's tier 1. And I've already got like tier 2 stuff already, so I'm better off just upgrading those. So I'm wondering what I'm gonna get out of this one. Cosmetics, that's for the loot crates and all. The more premium ones, I had to use like the actual diamonds to buy them.
Okay.
To get the diamonds, I would actually have to use actual money to get those. Is there not something you can get from the boss, like a cape or something? Well, these bosses, you just get some stuff. You can get like a cape and a headgear. But the best reward to get is this gauntlet here. Which, I guess is pretty much the best one, the best of all the rewards here. If you defeat any of the bosses in League of Maidens. And I guess they all come with their own gauntlets. Pretty much. Okay, not all of them, but you know, you get the gist. Yeah, that is interesting. Well, on Twitch, no. You rarely ever see someone get a gauntlet and use it live. But on Duber's Discord, I have seen him and a few others use their gauntlet in there. If I do ever get the gauntlet, I will definitely use it live on stream. Of course, there must be a reason they still added to the loot table after all. Now the other thing is, I don't know if the gauntlets are permanent once you obtain them. I'm pretty sure they are. Just like with the cape and the headgear. Intelligence is 11. Nah, I'll wait a little bit more till I prestige. I could get it right now, but I just wanna get my shards back up. Since I already spent 10k on just two additional rows here for more space. Primarily because of my valuables and stuff.
I will break your spine! I will break your spine!
Success!
Even if it's not fully buffed, it's still powerful. Since I got it at level 4. Well, powerful here in Freedom City. In the desert, I need to upgrade it more, just so that it's strong enough.
Fear you, think of it.
No, my E ability is pretty damn strong now. We're pretty much my strongest of all of my other abilities right now, since it's at level 6. Her in time before she can even summon the other enemies.
Success.
Thank you. almost got the one. Almost. Right, you know how the pets you got, like, the eagle and the little, moth character? Like, I wonder if they added, like, a fairy, into the game. Just like a little pixie, that just, like, floats around your shoulder. That'd be pretty nice to have. There's a mini lady you can customize. You've probably already seen it already, Apple, like the new, main menu, image. Indeed. Oh shit. You know what? Now take a good look at it. It reminds me of one of the ballerina dancers from Atomic Heart. I could think of a few changes, but that's just me getting very picky. Like what changes in particular? If you wanna talk about it. Nothing I want to admit on Twitch. Fair enough. Right then. Okay, you know what? I'll wait on that. I'll wait for that later. Alright, I guess I'll take on the world boss then. She was kind of a pain in the ass to fight, in my opinion, but the desert one was a lot stronger. And here she is.
Summon me.
Oh, that's annoying. Oh shit, but it works. Alright, I think I'm done. Yeah, she is actually beatable. You just gotta avoid her attacks. The other one in the desert was a pain in the ass for me to deal with. Any strongholds? No. Eternal suffering or eternal L's? Because it looks like eternal L's is what they're taking. Oh, wait, what? Okay, she counted. Okay, yeah, you know what? That makes sense. Okay. I thought I wasn't gonna count for the boss here on... for the boss count on the top left. Thank you. Okay, yeah, now I'm starting to collect a bunch of dark cubes. Which I should start trading those in for tier 2 ones. Since I can. Alright, let's do another boss run. Let's do six this time.
Fantastic! Fresh meat!
Yeah!
Well, that's a new record. I knocked her down at her most vulnerable state.
Excellent!
You're getting better at this, huh? Well, better, and just, yeah, just better in general on how I do these boss runs. Especially now that, my Q and E abilities use less magic as I continue to level them up. And already knowing when to strike. Yeah, I'm pretty much getting the hang of it, really. I guess you could say that I'm already used to each and every floor, both in the regular strongholds and in the boss strongholds. Since all I do is just use magic through and through with a little bit of gunfire and sword swinging.
Fantastic! Fresh meat!
Pretty sure by now you can already tell what my favorite ability is. At least for the warrior class. Not that I picked out for Leniri. Explains the thigh. The thigh is here. Just head to the I still want to stay in Freedom City to do two more boss runs, and then after that I'll head to the desert, the islands one, to trade in my tier 1 cubes, and then onto the desert, the beach island first, and then onto the necropolis desert. There we go. And I've already achieved 100 days with Leniri and League of Maidens.
Welcome to the general shop.
All right. Alright, now I'll do the prestige. So, let's see what happens. Well, obviously, I already know that my awakening level's gonna reset, but let's see what happens. And it doesn't tell me what my prestige is at. Yeah, they should tell me what my prestige level is, because I have no clue. Well, I already know it's level 1, but I wish there was like a little area here around my on the bottom left that tells me what prestige level I'm at, rather than trying to figure it out myself. Yeah, I don't know. But I guess I'll just level up again and then prestige and then one more time after that. And this time with the light cubes, I'm just gonna take like half of it every time. So in this case, 13. Oh, wait. Oh, it does tell me. Okay, never mind. Okay, you know what? Forget what I said. I already figured it out already. Okay, so you get this banner here to indicate your prestige level. Well, I guess I'm now in prestigehood. Yay for me. Onto the dailies.
Welcome to the attack training station, Cadet.
Oh, so there's two of you. Fuck up the training process. Okay, now I know. When you prestige, a little flag shows up with the prestige level you're at. If I want a supporter, it's definitely gonna take me a good ass while to prestige to level 25. Like, if it's gonna take me this long to get to level 25, then so be it. I guess they thought of that so many people stay playing. Yeah, that's probably why. Shit, then they did a pretty good job of keeping people glued into the game. Just really raking in that addicting scale. Just to have like a little supporter with you. Okay, actually, if anything, I wanna...
Hey there, cadet.
I want to update, Leniri's, character cons... or character design. Which, I need to use a ticket to do that. It was the one of the beauty tickets. And then I needed to redeem if I wanted to change Leniri's appearance. Which, if anything, updating her boobs. So, just... wait. No. Not too big, it's just I want to make them... I want to have like a little gap in between her chest, just so they look bigger. No, don't worry, I'm not gonna make it small. one ticket. Yeah, I'm not gonna touch the breast size. Just like about that. Yeah. And let me make sure that it's already locked. Okay. Oh yeah, oh that's a lot better. Oh yeah, much better. I'm a bit twitchy when I crouch. Anyways. Oh, okay. Hang on. Okay, so I guess a little bar is added onto one of your abilities after prestiging. That's my guess. like someone actually using the roleplay category for once, as it was intended for. There you go. I'll contribute to the roleplay. I rarely ever do roleplay as much, but I guess in this occasion, it's one of those rare occasions that I'll ever even consider doing roleplay. Is me already. Keeps wondering to herself how come there's a railway in the sewers, but no railway or subway station in. Good question. That's a really good question. At least 8.
Fear. You skin covered. I will break your spine! Fantastic! Fresh meat!
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Congratulations!
And hang on, I need to mute for a bit.
I Fantastic! Fresh meat! I will break them!
Excellent!
I will break the spine! Here, you stink of it! Fantastic! Fresh meat! Here, you stink of it!
that.
I guess I'm just that strong now that I have all of my abilities buffed out to the max. So time to head to the islands. And yeah, I had to mute my mic a bit just because there was some background noise that I didn't want to add into the VOD. So before I head to the islands, I need to go sell my stuff.
Welcome to the general shop. Thank you.
Alright, I should be good to go. Yeah, now that I'm looking at it, nothing really changes of my character except for the awakening level. Let me just check to make sure. Okay, yeah, my stats for the stem, for my stamina, HP, and magic don't change. Except for when I'm upgrading. For the most part. Alright. So, like, a mild new game plus. Something. I don't know, Apple. Alright, so let's conduct the trade. Okay, maybe not, because it looks pretty expensive to do that. Alright, time to head to the desert then. Thank you. Alright, let's see. So, just to get all of my stuff boosted, it takes me like approximately 2 hours during the stream to do that. Alright, I just want to see, like, how effective this is against these guys.
Ah, such a fresh kill.
Okay, so they're pretty strong. Not for long. Right, I'll just keep this here. And I'll be right back. Alright, any animation happens with Leniri? Pyramids, eh? Two round pyramids.
Creature.
Private Humphreys and Private Hawks.
Oh.
Nonsense.
Okay. Oh. Oh. Okay, yeah, that's way better. Alright, moving up to better armor. Moving up to better armor, then. So I guess I've got a brand new goal beside another goal besides getting better armor. Just collecting a lot of tier 1 cubes to upgrade to tier 2. I doubt I get 100 tier 2 cubes after I upgrade from tier 1, but we'll see what happens. Okay, so that makes me a lot stronger in attack. Okay, that's saying something. That's the sound of progress right there. To me, that sounds like progress right there. That's the camp. Maybe I have to kill these guys more to get the better armor. Probably. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely getting a lot stronger attack wise. And I need to go sell this stuff. It took them a while to realize I was there, right in front of them. Okay, so they were slightly slow. Oh, but for that, nah. All right, let's see. All right, I'll do the war helmet this time. I'm just gonna stop there.
such a fresh kill.
Yeah, so I'm guessing, yeah, so if I want to get better armor, it's definitely going to take me a lot longer than I thought. Right, I'll just finish up, give me another minute, and then I'm going to switch screens, and then wrap up the stream and find someone to raid. And just collect all of us. All right then. Let me just exit the game first. Okay, I doubt there's anyone streaming League of Maidens right now, so I'll just try to find someone playing something similar. Or maybe someone playing an anime game for all I know. Or I could stream someone that I follow. So that's another option. Yeah, I've already got someone in mind. Just give me a sec. So I'll just be raiding Lorianne Locke. And honestly, I don't know what she's doing right now, but I'm just gonna raid her anyway. So tomorrow's stream, I'll be playing Frostpunk. It's basically like a city builder steampunk game. And that tomorrow And tomorrow that will be my last stream playing Frostpunk. After that, I'm just gonna retire from the game. So, yeah. Goodbye.